Hey guys, I'm just about done with the second multi-suction electrolytic capacitor. There's actually four caps in this guy, so it's a bit of a challenge to get them all in there, but I managed it, and this will fit back in here just fine. As for the broken mounting wafer here, I used some two-part epoxy to glue that back together, and it seems pretty solid now. So, shouldn't be long before I can try powering this up. I finished restuffing and remounted the second electrolytic cap. I also populated all of the tube sockets. So now it's time for my least favorite part of the restoration process, which is the first power-up. Luckily, though, I can do it in stages on this set. This set uses a field coil speaker, which doubles as the power supply filter choke. I've left that disconnected so that disconnects B+ from getting to the set. But it will still allow me to check the voltage on this side to see that the doubler's working right. It will also allow me to see that the tubes are lighting up because the tube filaments are still connected. I would like to use my Variac, but unfortunately there's something not quite right with it. A while ago I blew the 5 amp fuse that came with it, and I've tried putting replacements and they're blowing too, so it might be something actually that fused inside of it, so I have to check on that. In the meantime though, I'll use my isolation transformer, which is critical anyway because this is a hot chassis set. And I've got it set on the low output in this switch set for a setting that will give me the lowest output voltage. I've also got a dim bulb tester set up, so I should be fairly safe there. I've got my meter connected across one of the tubes so I can see what the filament voltage is, and then I'll switch over and check the output of the voltage doubler. So here we go. Alright, light bulb lit up pretty bright, which is kind of what I expected because all these tubes are going to draw a bit of power, and that's only a 60 watt bulb. It should really be a bit higher wattage. But this is a good sign. Not only do I have AC volts going to that tube, but it's slowly increasing as it would as the tubes warm up. The resistance in them increases, so the voltage will start to rise. It's probably too low for me to see if they're actually glowing or not, though. Yeah, they all look pretty dark. Let's see. I'm flipping the switch on my ISO tap here to go to the highest voltage output, and I'm up to almost 3. Still don't see the tubes glowing, but that's only about half the voltage they would normally run at. I'm going to switch my meter around now and check for this B+ voltage here. I move the meter leads over to the main filter cap on the output of the doubler, and I'm getting about 172. It's about what I would expect considering I still have the 60 watt bulb in series. And if I turn the lights off and we look close, I think you can see that the tubes are actually glowing now. Faintly though, because again that 60 watt bulb is cutting the juice about down a bit too much. I've had it running for a few minutes. Nothing seems to be overheating or anything. So next I am going to pull out the speaker and hook it up. I've hooked up the speaker, which is an excellent condition, and I put in my little mini 5-inch test CRT. Now this set is kind of cheap and they don't have a filter capacitor on the high voltage output. They rely entirely on the capacitive coating, conductive coating on the pitcher tube, which is this gray coating out here. Well, this little test CRT doesn't have it, so what I did is I took a piece of aluminum foil, cut out a scrap, taped it on, and made sure it was making contact with this ground here, so that'll form at least a bit of a filter cap. Now that I trust the set isn't gonna go up in smoke, I removed the dim bulb tester so I know I have full voltage going to it, and all the tubes are lit up pretty well. And I put a test socket extender on the 6V6 output tube so I can check some voltages here. I should be getting about 190 volts and I've only got 114. And I'm sure that's because this resistor I put in here, remember, it was originally 7.5 ohm, and I went up to about 120, because I want to experiment with what the right value should be to compensate for the silicon diodes I replaced the selenium rectifiers with. So that needs to decrease, I think. But I do get a bit of a crackle out of the speaker. So that's something anyways. So now what I'm going to do is just tack another power resistor in parallel across this one to bring this value down. Okay, I put a 75 ohm resistor in parallel with the 120, so I'll have something like 45, 50 ohms of resistance in there now. So let's give this another try. Voltage starts up pretty high, then it should start dropping as the tubes heat up and start conducting. There it goes. Remember, there should be 190. But guess I'll have to decrease that resistance a little more still. Looks like we're going to bottom out somewhere around 150. Still, it should be in the right ballpark to give me some kind of life out of this, I think. Alright, getting a bit more of a louder buzz now, and it's responding fairly well to the volume control. Don't like that though. I would have thought there'd be some kind of crackle as I changed the channels. And, I guess there's no life on the pitcher tube, but I haven't adjusted any of the controls yet. Let's see. Well, let's start with brightness. It's on the far right here. Yeah, there we go. Hardly a picture, but that's great because it means the high voltage and flyback circuitry is working right in the horizontal oscillator. That's always the biggest pain to get that stuff working right. Pretty bright too. Let's see, and there's focus. Now focus is going to be all weird because these little test CRTs are auto-focusing. They don't need this big focus coil on here, so it actually makes a blurry when you've got that focus coil activated. Let's see. Now, I don't expect this to work right because, again, the voltage is a bit low, but let's see. That was vertical size control. Voltage dropped quite a bit once I got this picture going here. Alright, so there's no point in playing around with this. I know the voltage is too low, so I am going to cut this resistance down even more. A little more tinkering with the resistors has got me up to about 171, and now I've got more stable picture there. The volume control is definitely responding now. And the channel tuner seems to be functioning. Let's see if I can find my favorite channel 6. Or something. I don't have an antenna hooked up, so I think that's the next stage here. So I can get a stronger signal under it. I hooked up a pair of old rabbit ears, so let's see if that works any better. It's definitely louder, but you know, I don't think this is the station I was looking for. I was looking for a low power, light FM jazz station. We have 88.7, which is channel 6 on the dial. That's not the kind of music they play, so maybe it's just a radio station they're picking up. Ah, that's what I was looking for. Oh. It's coming through really clear. There's even a bit of a picture. So, all kinds of controls on the back here. Let's see, horizontal holds on the far end here. Yikes. Oh yeah. While I was adjusting that, the set was freaking out. Controls probably dirty. Is the controls rotating and losing the horizontal oscillator completely, which is pretty nasty. Let's see, there's a contrast control over here. Adjust the brightness a little. And as I said before, the focus is going to be off because these little touch CRTs aren't meant to have that focus magnet on there. But hey, not bad for a first power-up at all. Let's see what else is back here. Vertical height, vertical size, vertical linearity, horizontal linearity. Okay. The rest of those controls all need a test pattern generator to really set up properly. I guess what I'll try doing now is putting in the full 12-inch CRT, because the emissions weren't really great when I had it on my CRT tester, and I really want to find out how much or how bright a picture it can actually produce. Alright, here we go with a test of the full-size CRT. Now, if you recall, this picture tube uses an ion trap magnet, and that has to be adjusted right, or you don't see anything, so... I guess it's not in the right position. So, let's see... It's an image. I'm playing with the vertical hold and height now. Yeah, it's definitely something wrong with the vertical. Gets into some kind of weird oscillation where it goes, you know, shrinks down to a single line and expands back out. Horizontal hold's off too. I figured that I could get it stable with a small CRT, but not the big one. But at least I know the CRT's got some life now, is my concern. Playing with the brightness now, just focus. If I just get a stable picture, I could see how well this will focus. Alright, here we go. There's three controls for vertical. This is the vertical linearity, there's vertical height, and there's vertical hold, and they all interact with each other. There we go. Finally. Focus. I'm not crazy about that. I've got the focus all the way at one extreme. So you get it looking halfway decent. That might explain why there were those power resistors glopped in there. To kind of alter this a bit. Then again, I guess my B plus is still about 15 volts low, and that'll have some effect. Playing the ion trap magnet again. It's about as good as I can get now, just eyeballing it. I still need to get a test pattern generator hooked in. Well, I guess I'll pull a DT digital TV converter box and let's see how some actual programming looks. Okay, I've got a converter box hooked up, so let's give this a try. First, I gotta find the right station. Oh, there we go. The vertical's a complete disaster, like a figure. It's completely folded over here at the bottom.
I forgot to mention you, Mr. Rogers. You'll have to forgive me. My daughter and I were talking about something else.
Mr.
Rogers would like a dance floor.
It's a vertical hole. That's working
right. The dance floor is this way.
Say, this is great. And the band slickers and beats. Where do you meet the other fellas?
Yeah, that's pretty messed up. I'm going to have to do some more checking on that circuitry.
I was quite horrid to my mother today. If I could please have a little...
Nothing I'm doing is getting revived all over down there. One thing I like is I'm hearing some faint cracking and smell a little ozone. This high voltage leak under the CRT has got some electrical tape wrapped around it and whatnot. I think I better roll that a bit more thoroughly. Might even have to replace that wire. Nice thing. Let's see about that focus. This is not too bad. Yes, even though this picture tube tested pretty weak on emissions, it's plenty bright enough. This is the contrast control here. Yeah. This is fine tuning. Pretty sharp focus, so you can see the individual horizontal scan lines. It's pretty sharp. In fact, usually you want to unfocus it a bit, otherwise it looks, those scan lines are far too obvious. Not too bad, not too bad. So, let's check on that high voltage line, and go over the vertical circuitry. I cleaned off the CRT really good, especially around the high voltage connector, and I then made sure it was connected on solidly, and put a piece of foil down here to make sure the ground is making good contact, and I don't hear any high voltage crackling anymore. I still do get a few whiffs of ozone though, so I think there still might be some pinhole leaks perhaps underneath the chassis, even where the flyback is, or on the high voltage rectifier. I also tweaked the power resistors a bit more and got the voltages to be pretty much spot on, but now I cannot get horizontal sync anymore. As I rotate this control, you can hear that high-pitched tone changing in frequency. That tells me it's not in sync. And I'm getting multiples of the horizontal frequency, which is why I've got... Well, there we go. Okay, so sometimes it will lock, but I've got the control all the way at the extreme extent. And it's clearly not very stable, so... Got to do a bit more checking there. Hopefully it's just a resistor that's out of spec, or maybe one of these tubes is a little bit weak. It's getting late though, so I think I'm going to call it a night. Still very, very encouraging for the first power up. Considering how chewed up this set was, I thought it would be far more work to get it working. So I will pick up with the next video after I've made a little more progress, hopefully.